Calvin Castine back at the Lakeview Pub and Grill. It seems like only yesterday we were here for a big band reunion, the Starfires and the Gemtones, and then the next day we went to the golf club and the Drifters were having a reunion. And those were bands that got together in high school. And now we're going to talk to some guys who were so jealous of all that big band reunion stuff this summer that they said, we got to do that too. Well, I don't think they got together when they were in high school, though, because as this group,
no.
You may have gotten together in high school, but not as this group.
Right.
This group known as Old Friends, and there's a man missing right now, Dean Trombley. He's only been in about 57 bands, so, but he will be here. He will be certainly be a part of this evening's event. It's November 22nd. We're going to try to subdue Soupy here. November 22nd, 2014. And the first picture I saw of you, I went to Mark Murrell's Bible of bands,
yes.
75 years of music, and I saw an 82 picture. And I think one of you guys posted a picture recently that showed the last old friends get together, 88.
88.
So is it about roughly 6 years?
It was at the Candlelight.
Actually, it's probably longer than that. 82 was probably not the beginning. I think we started off and on from 77.
Yep.
Different lineups, but the three of us ended up there for the longest.
Okay, let's introduce yourselves.
I'm Don Superno, better known as Soupy.
Yep. Greg Roberts.
And Rick LaVenture.
I say LaVenture. Is that that bother you?
Nah, call me whatever. It doesn't matter.
LaVenture. Superno. French.
Now, there's a lot of Supernovs, but only one that got the nickname Soupy.
That's right.
How come that happened?
I have no idea. probably around 12, 13 years old.
Just calling you that.
Yeah.
Steph, Robbie, and Lobby. Okay. You got together. I know there's. You guys were together. I think Neil Walker was in a band with you. Some of you guys, not all of them.
Yep.
Bushy.
Yeah, Soupy and I. And
who's this guy here?
Yes.
Another guy here.
This is when holds our band together.
The last of the Mohicans.
the late Dean Trombley.
But I was here earlier.
He was here. I know. He was here earlier. All right. You were saying. Got together initially when?
I think 77 probably. We started playing off and on with different people.
Yeah.
But it was old friends, and it just kind of developed with different people along the way.
Was it always old friends when the first time you guys got together?
Yes. Yep. Yep. Yep.
Jimmy Rochester.
He's old.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Danny Rochester for a while.
Yep. How about the movie star?
Movie star?
Remember the movie star? Oh, you're going to be movie stars someday.
Yeah. But we won't mention a name on that one.
But. No, Ronnie Langlois.
Oh, yeah.
He played with us for a while.
Yep.
When we were old friends. And then basically just went to the three of us, Soupy, myself, and then we got Dean in, and the band started blooming a little bit, and we had fun right to the end.
Yes, we did.
We're still having fun.
We're still having fun.
Up until 19, so you guys haven't played together until maybe a month ago, since 1988?
Since 1988, yeah.
Sounds like 16 years?
26
years. 26 years, oh my
26.
God.
26, yep.
And Rick was telling me earlier that you got together and it was like you'd never...
Pretty much.
Apart, huh?
3 months to go right back and
forth. Yeah, it's coming pretty good, actually.
Right?
I'm very happy.
Right?
Yeah. Yes.
Soupy, have you been in any bands since Old Friends?
Not really, no. Not to speak of, no.
Okay, so...
No.
Did you keep drumming at home?
Or? No, not at all.
So you haven't touched drums in a while, or what?
Once in a while, I'd sit in with somebody, you know, if I went out to a bar or something. Other than that, I didn't really play much.
Oh, wow.
Just working all the time, so... Just didn't have time.
Okay.
I miss it.
All right, now... It was what, an anniversary or birthday party? What was it, Greg?
Anniversary. My Lisa and I's 25th anniversary.
Rick's post on Facebook,
and it sounded good. I said, hey,
yep.
These guys get together again. I want to be there. And
yep, exact. And this is a nice get-together here. It's a nice thing for the children and kids up to 18 to you know, the less fortunate to be able to have a few Christmas gifts this year. And I would, I think it's great. It's been really good.
We should point out that this whole thing is a fundraiser. You come in, you bring a gift for a child, unwrapped gift, and that's your admission to the event here at the I'm going to call it the Pavilion, but it's Lakeview Pub and Grill. Now, Dean, you got involved what year with these guys, if you can recall?
Right after your 40th birthday.
It would have been 83. Probably 1984.
Yeah. Oh, so you were with them for 4 years then?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and that was back in the day when the clubs were still... Yeah. A lot of action, and we played a lot. Whew. We did a lot of weddings.
By
the
way,
the candlelight was one of our mainstays.
Yep.
Yes.
Back in those
classic
days.
Classic four in Plattsburgh.
Classic four in Plattsburgh.
I may have to step in front of here, so if you don't mind, don't be offended.
That's all right. That's okay.
Don't get out your paintbrush and write things on my back.
I kid your cousin, Joey Trombley, about having so many cousins. I think you've got more cousins than Joey Trombley has.
Oh, boy.
Because that large Trombley family, that yeah. Your mother, and then the Roberts side.
You know. Oh, my God. I think some of them I wouldn't even recognize today. You know, you lose track of a family, you know, as time goes on. And then somebody will come in and, well, I'm so-and-so. I'm like, wow, I never would have recognized you. Remember when you were like this young and, yep. Families.
I've got a big family on my mother's side, the Trudeaus, but only about three of them stayed locally, and they're all spread out.
Yep.
Most of your relatives grew up right around here.
Yep, they stayed right here. Yes.
Well, they're not all going to show up tonight, I hope.
Oh, no. We might have to dig a few of them up, buddy.
Your cousins, I'm talking about.
Oh, cousins, yeah, okay. The whole family, yeah. Might not be good.
That's good.
To dig a few.
Now, have you played anything since?
Not at all.
Sorry to step
okay,
on you there.
So, okay.
No,
nothing. So
no, never. Never played. Never.
So here you're having an anniversary party, and they put you to work.
Yes.
Now, that doesn't seem fair.
Well, you know, I played at my own wedding, so why not play at my 25th?
You couldn't afford a real band.
What was that? I didn't charge much.
Well. Let's see, 26 years ago with old friends, so who were you playing with? 25-year anniversary.
Yep. We were, it was us.
Yep, that's right, three of us actually. And then
you must have got together, it's about 89?
It was 88. October 88.
Okay, so it's your 26th anniversary.
Yep, 26.
Okay.
So back then, no, I wasn't married. I was getting done playing, so
and
I would
married.
Get married. Yeah. I told Lisa, I said, if I, you know, when I get married, I'm going to quit playing in the band.
No, and, she told you that. She told
get it
that.
Straight there. So she told me, you better not play in that band when I get married, when we get married. So I'm like, okay, dear, you know, whatever. And now she wants to play in a band. So what's that tell you after 26 years?
She wants to get rid of you.
The marriage is over.
Thank you, dear.
Now, Rick, I know you haven't played in as many bands as Dean here has, but you've played in a few?
Oh, yeah. I played around here. I played in Rome, New York for a while when I was out there in the service. I played with some country bands out there. I played with several bands around here over the years. Ever since we got done with these guys, I've been playing except for maybe a couple of years with different groups around the area.
So you're used to late nights?
Not anymore. Midnight is late enough now.
Yes, I noticed tonight you're playing till midnight, and back when I was younger, things didn't get going till midnight.
That's right.
Now we all want to be home and snoring at midnight. Now, Dean, I'm going to put you on the spot here. Now,
yes, you've
been talking about us sitting down and doing the whole list of your bands one of these days. Are you going to get any closer to being ready for that? I think the world wants to see that. All the pictures.
Yeah, most of the people have a hard time believing I'm still living. We will do that. We will do that in the very near future.
Now, this is your second reunion for the year here. You had the Starfires early in, and this one here. So you're going to do reunions of all 57 bands?
That'll be a tough one.
Well, there are some of those folks that are deceased.
Yeah.
There'll be a plan. It'll work. I promise.
Now tonight, Overdrive is the band that's playing, and that includes Rick LaVenture and Dean Tremblay. And who else is in that band?
Travis Marciano and Kevin Tremblay.
Okay. And then the second set, it's going to be you guys, right?
Yes.
And if there's anybody left in the place after that, back to Overdrive again.
Overdrive will finish.
Nobody argued with me when I said anybody left in the place after that.
There's anyone left here.
That's right.
I'm hoping.
Anything else, guys, that you think the world ought to know here? I know I'm looking forward to it.
I still have a lollipop that Carl Kastein gave me. Yeah. I was on the bus. Yes. I still have that in my... They gave me that for a reason, you know, to try to keep me quiet back when I was a kid. He always told me, he says, Greg, I'm going to get you a big lollipop someday, and I'll be a son of a gun. He come to the house one day with a big lollipop, and I said, I'll never get rid of it. I still have it. I think one tastes very good now.
And you still haven't been a good kid.
I still have it. I'm still mouthy.
Sit down, Greg.
Yeah. If that lollipop ever disappears, we'll know he's reformed.
He's finally behaving himself.
Anything else, guys?
No. Thank you. Thank you for the interview.
There you go.
Thank you very much.
Next sound you'll hear here will be old friends together for the second time since 1988. Thanks, guys.
Thank you. 26 years ago, last month, the four of us had a farewell show at the Candlelight in Edinburgh. About 400 people were there. What a crazy night. So, this year, last year we were going to do a 25th, and we didn't have a 25th anniversary. This year, it was Greg and Lisa's 25th anniversary, and we said, yeah, what the hell, 25, 26, who cares? So, we put this together for the anniversary party, and we said, you know what, this is a charity, we're going to raise toys for underprivileged kids, why not bring these guys back, and we had a blast last night, so we can try it again. Thank you everybody for coming this evening. Oh, yeah. Anyone that owns any Mustangs out there, we'll see you for you. Oh, we give a 26-year break between the two.
All right, is there any pretty women out here? I see quite a few. All right.
We're now serving
we
of you guys was 25, 26, 27 years ago. You know, one of our favorite things to do is beach boys. So we figured we couldn't really ask about doing some beach boys.
We have a 62 Chevy bubble top with a 409 on it. She's real fine, my poor guy. She's real fine, my poor guy. We'll be right back.
I'm Thank you. Let me take this a minute and officially thank everyone for coming out here tonight and making this gift-raising event such a success. I mean, it's just marvelous to see everybody. The presents and the gift cards and the cash and whatever has accumulated tonight is going to be just outstanding. Real quick, Christmas Magic is a group of volunteers that help to provide gifts at Christmas time for families who can't really afford to give their children as nice a Christmas as they would like to. And the gifts that are raised here go to that bureau, and it's only a segment of what that bureau does, but this helps them fill the wish lists of parents that are trying to give their children a little nicer Christmas than they would be able to without the help of Christmas Magic. And I know tonight that we have accumulated a real, real load of beautiful things. And thank you, everybody. Give yourselves a hand because you're just terrific. It's just great. Thank you so much. This is the fifth year we've done this to help Christmas Magic. And after this year, we will certainly continue to do it because this has been just tremendous. Thank you so much.
Do you think we should recognize anybody special? Yes. Cindy, if you see where the camera is and you go back to one table, you'll find Cindy Bombardier sitting there. And we're going to acknowledge her because Cindy is the one that organizes this. Her and her little elves. They figure out who gets what. They give out families. Many of the companies in the area sponsor a family. And she takes care of all of that with little elves that go all over the place. They get stockings from a company in Vermont, I believe, right? Socks, yeah. And whatever else they can lay their hands on. They've been known to farm out some bicycle assemblies.
This all starts back in July, believe it or not. Again, thank you so much. Cindy, thank you. I'm
We'll be right back.
Andrews. There's something on the still side for you. Something from, yeah, it's an April one. Thank you.